Hey, welcome back to part two of our haul video here on the channel. If you haven't already checked out part one, go check it out. It's going to be here on the channel for you to check out. So we are, 11 pops into this haul. And
I don't even know how many there is left to go.
Yeah, I don't either. These came from Big Apple Collectibles. This is rounding out my soul collection.
Ooh.
So had to pick up.
You have them all now?
I do have all of them now, yes. Had to pick up the remainders of the souls because it is my all-time favorite animated film. And this is what a pop should look like. Not this. Not saying don't go shopping at Smyworld, because this is honestly the first time I've ever gotten pops in this kind of a condition.
Right.
Usually they're in much better condition, but just to kind of give you an idea of, you know, the difference in quality here.
Yeah, one looks brand new, the other...
Not so much. And the tops, you can kind of see the top is...
A little pushed in.
Pushed in on this one. This is like a perfect box, mint condition. I do recommend going to Big Apple Collectibles because they have a mint condition kind of guarantee. So you're definitely gonna get really good looking boxes right there.
Honestly, I don't see much of a difference to the original 22. I understand that he's grinning, but
she. Here it is, right there, 22.
Oh, huh.
So there's your difference.
Eyebrows.
And her mouth.
In her mouth.
In her mouth. So this is the original 22 when she's all sweet and happy and whatever, and then grinning is when she, like, her real personality comes out.
Yeah. Cute.
I forget, who is the voice of 22 again?
I was just thinking that. Why were you saying?
I can see her. We don't feel like looking it up, so let us know down in the comments. Who is the voice of 22? Please help us.
Yeah. Too lazy to Google.
Too lazy. So that is the 22. And then last but not least, to complete...
I could have sworn you already have this one.
No, Mr. Mittens?
Yeah.
Mm-mm. I have Mr. Mittens with the pizza.
You don't have this one?
I don't have Soul World. I have that one.
Okay.
Trust me, I know because of the Funko app.
And you keep that updated regularly?
When the moment I hit buy on a website, I add it to the collection.
Hmm.
Yep. So now I have Mr. Mittens, Soul World. Look at that cat.
Plump.
Very plump.
Nice and plump.
Mm-hmm.
He ain't even got no feet.
No feet.
Just plump.
So that is all the Soul Pops. What I'm definitely gonna, what we're definitely gonna do here on the channel is we're definitely going to, for all of our completed sets, we're gonna make separate videos for those, highlighting a completed set. So that is definitely going to be included in that collection of videos, as well as Black Mirror, Make-A-Wish, and I think that's it. I don't have all the monsters.
Correct.
All right. We're making our way downtown. Walking fast. Faces pass.
And I'm homebound.
all right, here we go. Let's do this one, shall we? This one I had. This one I had back in the day. And obviously when I got rid of everything, he went along with it, so he had to come back into the collection because he is my all-time favorite villain on The Walking Dead.
From Edition 3.
Yeah. This is the governor. This is the standard governor. There's a, I think a different version of him. I don't know.
Without the eye patch?
Yeah, with, like, the bandage. I think it's some kind of an exclusive. I don't know if it's a chase or what, but, yeah, there he is right there. Negan's great, don't get me wrong. Negan's the most ruthless.
Yeah.
But the governor's the most realistic villain. Negan's a little too over the top for me. So.
Don't do Jeffrey Dean Morgan that way.
Hey, don't do David Morrissey that way. Let us know down in the comments if you're a Walking Dead fan. Who are you, Team Governor or Team Negan? What do we got here? All right, let's dig in, baby.
What's this?
This is Mr. Willy freaking Wonka. In a pop protector, too.
In a pop protector.
So, love that. What?
I was trying to remember the quote. You get nothing. You lose. Oh. Good day, sir.
When he yells at them at the end.
Yeah, that's my favorite part. The whimsical wonderland of the chocolate factory. You lose.
Yeah. I don't think I want every single Willy Wonka in the collection, but yeah. I do want Willy Wonka, and I think I want Charlie.
Charlie annoys me.
Yeah, he's interesting.
He annoys me.
I think I want the whole top row. I don't want the kids.
No.
But I do want the top row. So I want Grandpa Joe, the Oompa Loompa, Charlie, and I have Willy right here. Look, I mean, this and Young Frankenstein go back and forth between my favorite Gene Wilder films. But Willy Wonka, I mean...
Classic.
Absolutely classic.
I have yet to see Young Frankenstein, surprisingly enough.
Oh, you're going to love it. You're absolutely going to love
it.
I'm sure. I think we're in agreement here. Let me know if I'm wrong. I believe we're both bigger fans of this film.
Yes, but you never were. You never were. You preferred Johnny Depp's version.
I liked Johnny Depp's version a slight bit more because it is more faithful to the novel. I will say that. This one has a little too many liberties taken. But watching Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, it's just a little too creepy.
Not even that. It's too...
For that story, it's a little too creepy.
It's not that it's too creepy. I think it's supposed to be, but I don't like all the flashbacks. It's too flashbacky.
The flashbacks definitely take away. I agree.
Like, take all those out, and you probably don't even have a feature-length film, but you definitely have a better one.
Yes. And the overabundance of CGI.
Yeah.
Does not help it at all.
No.
The practicality of this film, the sets, everything... just takes it to a whole other level. Granted, the chocolate river in this one looks like dirty bathwater. It does not look like chocolate, in my opinion. The one in Tim Burton's version looks like chocolate. But that's a minor gripe. I definitely, if I had to choose between watching one or the other, I would take this any day of the week. Also, I feel like a popular complaint about this one is Cheer Up Charlie.
Oh, I hate that. I hate that song.
Yeah, so I feel like people would cut that.
I do skip. Like, whenever I find myself watching Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory, I do skip that part every time.
Yeah. Yeah, it's definitely an interesting choice of song. So this next one is something that I'm not a fan of in general of what it is, but it's my boy Freddy. This is the 8-bit Freddy Funko exclusive.
I'm conflicted.
Look at him. And look at that beautiful sticker right there.
Looks like Christmassy.
It does look a little Christmassy. And then on the back here, you got Funko Shop exclusive.
I'm conflicted.
Yeah, I think it.
I like that the side is also.
That's a neat little detail.
8-bit.
Yep.
There. Rather than the traditional font. And different.
And this one was also fairly darn cheap, so.
For a Freddy.
For a Funko Shop limited edition exclusive. The sticker at the bottom there is kind of peeling up.
Uh-oh.
It's alright. It's a little minor gripe. I'm not going to try to fix it. I've learned to just kind of accept how it comes and move on. Another Freggy.
Freggy.
What else? Did I not tell you this was an epic haul? This is my very first ever. This is a Walking Dead. It's a Walking Dead.
It doesn't even say the series on there.
It's a Walking Dead.
Or the edition, whatever.
But it's my first ever supply drop.
Wrapped in plastic and everything.
Yeah. So The Walking Dead has a box, like a monthly box that they do.
Don't you have the black and white, Negan?
Yes, but that's not a supply drop.
What is it?
That's a Toys R Us.
Don't they have a Negan in the supply drop? Or is that the black and white Daryl?
Yeah, they do. They had, they might have two. But definitely the one that I'm thinking of is the black and white one where he has blood on him. He's clean shaven. Mm. That's a supply drop as well. But yes, this is... I like this one because it's... So it's Rick Grimes. He's gold. Mm-hmm. I like this one because he's the OG character. It starts with Rick. Mm-hmm. So I like that he's gold. It's like symbolic of how important he is.
He's number one.
He's so valuable to the story. I mean... And I love that sticker.
Wow. Of all the pop televisions, he's number 13.
Oh, absolutely adore this one. This one, I believe, came from Smileworld? So see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Where it's like, this one, well, I mean, this is mint.
This is absolutely it literally came plastic wrapped.
Yeah. So it's very interesting. But, yeah. Got Rick Grimes added into the collection. The supply drop exclusive.
No, that came from $7.
Oh, okay. Sorry. It came from $7 a pop, as did this one right here.
Ooh. I have not seen this movie just yet, but I have seen the first two.
This one is really unique because I totally forgot that they even made pops of this particular film.
Oh, I didn't.
This is Lady Liberty from The Purge election year.
Yeah, I feel like I've seen the Big Pig quite a bit in our pop hunts.
Yeah. I mean, this box is, you talk about mint, this just feels mint. And I love it. I love the, like, she is, like, I think the most iconic of the characters, because when you look at posters of The Purge election year, which is a great film, by the way, when you look at the posters, she's front and center.
Yeah, I like how that her mask, like, isn't just a decal. I like that it's all, like, it's embossed.
Yeah.
Like,
I love the Purge films. I've only ever seen the first three, the original trilogy, because they're written and directed by James DeMonaco, the creator of the Purge series. 4 and 5, he only wrote them. He didn't direct them.
What's 4 and 5? What are those?
The fourth one is the first Purge, and then the fifth one is the Forever Purge. So there's that. And if I do get to complete the Purge election year series, then I'll do it. But I'm not actively trying to complete the set.
Yeah, but that's just a cool pop.
And out of all the ones, this is the one I would have wanted because, like I said, she is the. She's like the mascot for the film, in a way.
The face.
The face, if you will. Alrighty, here. Yeah. Next up, we got the Hot Topic exclusive Child's Play 2 Chucky
on cart.
Cart. So we have to see Child's Play 2 to understand this. We have not seen this film yet.
Where's he feet?
But, I gotta love how he's, like, beaten up and he's, like, crawling on a... cart.
Those remind me of those little scooters like you had in gym class that you would sit on and push yourself off of.
Yep.
I don't know what they were actually for, but that looks like it. Poor kid.
He's on his way out in that film. Whoop. Camera slow. Whoop. Next up is the FYE exclusive Michael Myers Blood Soaked.
I feel like I keep going like, ooh, but that's because it's like, I'm excited to see these come through.
Yep. This one is cool because this is the OG kind of mold of Michael Myers.
I don't like the expression on his face, though, like the eyebrows. He's supposed to be...
Yeah, he's like mad.
Yeah, he's supposed to be expressionless.
He looks like he's mad.
Also, the mask doesn't even have eyebrows. And why is it on the side he doesn't have eyebrows, but the pop does?
Yeah. It's an interesting detail. So, yes, sir. No that eyebrows.
Make it make sense.
And then eyebrows. Either way. Hey, whoa. Stack's getting out of control here. All those boxes are taken care of. These boxes are taken care of. That's taken care of. Let's go here. Because Lord knows. Lord knows we've seen this guy enough times. Here he is, direct from Target, and he's in really good condition, so I'm happy that I ordered from the website.
Oh, yeah.
Well, this is John Hammond. This is, I feel like I've said it here on the channel, but when we do our year-end favorite pops that came out in 2022. I feel like this is going to end up on maybe both of our lists, but definitely my list, because...
Not my list.
It's just, look at that. It comes with the gates to Jurassic Park and John Hammond, the creator of Jurassic. So it's like this pop deluxe town encapsulates everything about Jurassic Park.
Yeah, it reminds me a lot of Universal.
And a lot of Universal, yep. And the box is, like, gorgeous. So, props, Target. Wow. Props, Target.
Props, Target.
Yeah, because normally if you see this guy in stores, he's going to have some kind of damage.
Badgering.
Yeah.
Getting out of control.
I think we have two more, and then that's it. I'm not mistaken. Okay, yeah. Cool. So this is a two-pack, I believe. Twofer?
Twofer.
The heck just came out? Oh, okay. let's try to keep this secret here. Yeah, no peeking. Okay, next, first, Mr. DNA.
Mr. DNA.
Diamond.
Do you not have that one? Why am I thinking? I'm just going insane.
So his body is what's covered in?
And his teeth.
The diamond.
His teeth.
And his teeth. And his eyebrows, maybe.
Yeah.
This one is for Haley. Close your eyes. Keep your eyes closed, but make sure you hold your hands out. So, yeah. Now, I'm looking at it, like I'm looking at it, and I'm not entirely thrilled with the window, but maybe that won't bother.
Okay.
Maybe it won't bother you.
I'm looking at the window. Like, it's the box that I'm worried about.
Okay, the box is great.
Okay. Can I look?
Mm-hmm.
Ooh. Yeah, window's fine. What do you mean?
The streak right there.
Oh, that doesn't bother me.
All right, show the folks and be careful of all the stuff going on here.
Yeah. Oh my God. Okay. So now my They Live pop collection is complete.
Yep, you have all three.
It's complete.
With John Nada.
Nada.
Nada. John Nada.
Wow.
Can the camera pick up the window though?
I thought you meant it was gonna be damaged.
No.
Streak doesn't bother me.
You see that little streak right there, everybody? It's complete.
It's complete.
And we're not giving this one away.
No. Mine.
Hers. and then I figured let's end the video, you know, with a bang. So let's save the biggest dude for last.
Big dude. Okay.
A 10-incher. A 10-incher, which I've said, I don't know if I've said it on the channel, but I've said it out loud to Haley. These are the only ones I am willing to open.
Yeah, of course.
Because of their size.
Mm-hmm.
So take them out of the box and display them somewhere. Currently, I only have one 10-inch in my collection. That is the Joker from Batman 89, the GameStop exclusive.
I also have only one, and it's a troll. It's like one of the good luck trolls, like from the 90s.
Yeah.
And it has rainbow hair, like real hair, not plastic.
Yeah. So I figured I'll probably end up changing my mind down the road, but I figured the 10 inches I'll save exclusively for like my favorite villain characters.
Is this the last one, like of all the boxes?
Yeah. This is it.
And I'm scared.
So it is the mega 10-inch Michael Myers.
Ooh.
Right there. And it's got it's got the wrapping around it.
Mm.
So let's see if I can...
The wrapping...
Peel it off. It's just so that the window stays
protected. Yeah. Because if you have a plastic window that big, it's bound to be flimsy.
Yep. So there he is. And this is the new mold of Michael Myers. He's huge, and I just would love to see him taken out and displayed.
Oh, of course. We need to find a good place for him.
Somewhere.
Please.
The only complaint with this particular design pop is these eyes that are very much reminiscent of H2O, which they originally made the Halloween H2O pop with this mold, and then they literally just copied and pasted the mold and put the original Halloween on top here. So essentially what we got here, and I'm a little conflicted about it, but I can get past it. I'm sure Dave McRae and people like that can't. What we have here is we have a Halloween 1978 box with a figure that is, like, let's be real. It's Halloween H2O from, like, 1997, 8, something like that. Whenever H2O came out. So.
20 years after the original.
Yeah, look at that. Wouldn't you know?
Did you not realize that? That's why H2O, Halloween 20?
H2O. I was like, I thought there's a lot of water in this film. I'm kidding. Where am I? But yeah, anyways, this dude will be coming out of the box. Actually, you know what? Since he is coming out of the box, why don't we quickly do an unboxing, a true unboxing here.
You're unhinged.
On the channel. What, he's coming out of the box. These ones do not remain in their boxes.
Although I still haven't taken mine out.
So when you take a 10-inch out, they have two pieces of plastic that keep them protected.
It's like scary.
Sacrilegious.
Yeah, and this is like scary to me, just to like see him out. Like, I feel like he's gonna come to life like Chucky. He's literally gonna turn into Chucky and get me in my sleep.
Oh yeah, baby. Oh yeah.
Oh, I don't know how I feel about him.
Look at that dude.
Oh, I'm sleeping with one eye open tonight.
Look at that knife. Look at the knife.
I'm literally sleeping with one eye open.
Would you like to hold him?
Ew. Ew. Why is he so heavy?
It is bizarre to hold a pop if you're an inbox collector. It's definitely bizarre.
It's really weird. It feels like a baby.
Go to sleep. Go to sleep. Oh, we're still filming. Call it a night here. Hopefully you enjoyed. I know I love watching haul videos, so hopefully you enjoyed watching this particular haul video with a total of 3, 6, 9, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26 Funko Pops.
26.
Is that the largest on this channel that we've ever done a haul for?
Yes.
Let me know down in the comments. I don't think I'm going to put that in the title of the video, so we're not too clickbaity. I don't think I'm going to do that. But you never know. You never know. But yeah, love it, love it, love it. Oh, I can't wait to display him with the Joker. Like have him and the Joker looking at each other. Oh, that's going to be so cool.
I don't like him.
I love it. I love the 10 inches and taking them out. And it's weird to think that that's 10 inches.
Yeah.
But I guess it is, huh?
It looks like a baby.
Yeah. It's so cool. Oh, it's so cool. You know what? I do understand why people take pops out of boxes. You know? If you line them all up on rows and stuff and stack them, it's really cool looking. But yeah, anyways, we're done rambling. Thank you for watching this video. Hopefully you like what we do here on the channel. If you do, stick around, because we got more coming. Anything else?
And as always, keep being
fans of something. Anything you would like to say, Michael?
I hope not. Goodbye.
Wait, hold on, he's talking. No, he's got nothing.
I'm going to bed.